Hey kids, today we're making a black crow feathered wreath for Halloween.
It's cooking and crafting, yeah, cooking and crafting. It's YouTube's best for creative things, it's cooking and crafting.
What we're going to need is a wreath. You can use, you know, a grapevine wreath or one of those kind of looking hay type, I'm not sure what to call them, wreaths. I just found this one and I thought that would be pretty cool. But now that I realize it, it probably would be a little bit better if I did have a grapevine wreath, but whatever. So let's see what this is. It doesn't give a measurement. They're 12 inches, duh. Okay, 12 inch foam wreath. And you could probably use two of these black feather boas. I picked them up at Savers for $5.99. The problem I did was I wasn't sure if I wanted to make it Halloween-y or if I wanted to make it just totally black. And I've decided to do it totally black, and I wish I had picked up two of them. So I'm gonna have to kind of play with the spacing. You also want a crow or a few crows, actually, if you want. But here he is, and he was $2.97 at Walmart. Small crow. All right, and then we have some black pipe cleaners, or as they're called, fuzzy sticks. And we're going to use this as our wire or attachment pieces. So let's put him on the side. And this is so super simple. It's not even funny. The problem is, here comes the cat and they love these feathers. They go nuts. So anyway, I'm just going to grab one of these. I'm going to wrap it around the feathers. And then I am going to secure it to the wreath by just twisting. No, kitty. You're gonna get hurt. I have my hot glue gun there. All right, and then all you're gonna do is you are going to twist or go in and out of this wreath, and you're gonna just go all the way around the wreath form. And like I said, it needs two, but I only picked up one of each color. So I am gonna play with the spacing. So it will be much thicker than what you will see here. See, it falls just a little shy. So I'm just gonna space it out, but hopefully so that you can't really see the green too much. And I'm gonna go ahead and maybe I'll put a little bit of the black and orange on the side and have it like that on the side. So I'm gonna end this one off with another one of these fuzzy sticks. And I'm gonna go ahead and secure it. And I'm gonna cut a little piece of this black and orange one here. Same concept with the twisty tie, securing it. And I'm just gonna finish this off and we'll be right back. We're gonna finish this off by adhering or sticking our crow into the middle of our wreath here. And we're gonna use the same thing now. These feathers will shed like crazy. I've got about half of them down on the ground on the carpeting, so just be aware that that's what's going to happen. So I'm just going to take my crow, and on his little feet there, maybe I'll just go in and out so that I make sure that I have him well strapped down. So I went in and out. And I'm going to just go ahead and tie him with the pipe cleaner. And then I am going to get my wreath hanger. And I'm going to go hang him on our door. So there you go. Crow feathered wreath. I hope you enjoyed. It's so simple. There's no reason you can't decorate for Halloween.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we have to say goodbye, make sure you comment and subscribe. And it would be so great.